Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord.
Hallelujah, Church. Amen. Oy. Wow. We welcome back our American brethren. Welcome back. We know and we do believe that you have a lot of wonderful and powerful stories and testimonies how the Lord blessed your American venture. So we will be very happy and keen to listen and hear from you. Hallelujah, Lord. Are we enjoying ourselves? Welcome again to each and every one of us in the house of the Lord. Amen. Amen. Are we glad to be in the house of the Lord today?
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Before we continue, can I invite and encourage each and everyone to, I know we have already started praying for it, but if we press on to pray for our next Sunday or next week activities, it's going to be Holy Week next week, and we know and we do believe that when Holy Week comes, the power of the Lord is very vivid. Makikita talaga natin yung kapangyarihan ng Panginoong kumikilos doon. Amen, Church. Because in history, no one can prove, no one can pinpoint when Christmas actually happened. But when you look at Holy Week, if you go back to history, talagang on calendar, that is tabulated. Kaya mga kapatid, amen? So if you are yet to file your annual for next week, please press on hard. Let us all come and gather together next week to worship the Lord. Amen? And let us be excited. And of course, we have our Good Friday service as well in here. In the evening, in the night. Our TGIF service will going to be here. Amen, Church? Hallelujah. And thank the Lord for His good countenance. Thank you for the Lord for how He has been joining us this morning. And thank you sa lahat ng buhay to all the life of our brothers and sisters whom the Lord have chosen to minister to us today. We just continue to thank the Lord for their life. Can we give the Lord the greatest clap offering for the life of all the people who stood here this morning? Hallelujah. May the Lord to bless you and honor the ministry and the work that He has set upon you. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Most gracious Lord and Heavenly Father, Ama, maraming salamat po, Father God. Lord, we cannot thank you enough sa kabutihan mo sa aming buhay. We cannot thank you enough, Father God, na kumikilos ka at gumagalaw ka sa aming buhay. Sa bawat araw, sa bawat oras, Father God. Especially dun sa mga moment, Father God, na hindi ka namin nararamdaman. Because we know and we do believe that those moment na hindi ka namin nararamdaman, it's because Jesus, you are earnestly praying and interceding with us and for us. Kaya maraming salamat. Father God, we continue to offer this day unto you, Lord. Even, Lord, as we study your word once more. Father God, my prayer is, hide me behind you. Cover me, O God, with your wings, O Lord. Lord, let none of this word, Father God, is a reflection of what is in my mind. Let none of these words be a reflection of what is in my heart, because I am just mere mouthpiece, Father God, of you. Ikaw po ang titinig, ikaw po ang magsasalita, Panginoon. Lord, ang dasal ko ay pakalinisin, pakabanalin mo ako, Lord. Ang aking kaisipan, ang aking puso, the deepest crevices of my innermost being, upang sa ganun, Father God, you can freely use me, Father. Maraming salamat. As for all the people, Lord, ang aking mga kapatid who are seated here right now, and to all the people who are joining us online, Lord, mangusap ka sa kanila, Father God. Though your word is general, but I know and I do believe by faith na meron kang mensahe sa buhay ng bawat isa. And Father God, we intercede and we pray and we agree for the life of each and everyone, that today is the day na matatanggap nila, na marireceive nila, Father God, the secret, Father, the secret, Lord, na you have been wanting to share them. Maraming salamat. We continue and we remain to be excited and expectant. Holy Spirit, we urge you, we invite you, and we desire you to continue to move in our midst. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Yung kanta po natin kanina, it talks about change. Amen. Amen. And we desire change. Amen po? Amen. Sino po dito yung hindi nagdi-desire ng change? I think, sabi nga nila, although malayo pa ang burr, wala pang sumisilip, pero sabi nila, life is a constant change. Amen po. So, ganun din po mga kapatid, no? That each and every one of us desire change. Oh, si Sep-Sep, she changed a lot. Oh, I was really amazed at the level ni Sep-Sep ngayon, no? If you were here yesterday, you will understand what I meant. But hallelujah. Maraming salamat sa Panginoon for change. Amen. The song that we have sung earlier is, ano ba yung unang kanta? Change my heart. Yeah, change my heart, oh God. That is the prayer. Now, open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Yun yung unang line ng request natin sa Panginoon kanina. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Why are we singing that song na, Lord, open the eyes of my heart? Because there is that desire for that heart to be changed. Amen. There is that desire for that heart to be changed. And in order for that heart to be changed, mga kapatid, di ba, kailangan natin, we cannot change our heart. It is only the consuming fire of the Lord. Amen. It is only that consuming fire of the Lord. So my dear brothers and sisters, today we are going to learn the word of the Lord. And it is my prayer na itong word ng Panginoon na to, and hindi lang po siya sound, hindi lang po siya magandang pakinggan, but it is my prayer that let this be a fire that will consume our heart. Amen. In order for our heart to have a change. Amen, church. Can we enter, my dear brothers and sisters, into that corporate agreement and say, Lord, we desire a change today. Amen. Hallelujah. Lord, I desire a change today. And Father God, I pray, I intercede, Father, na hindi lang ako, but ganun din kaming lahat, that we will change. Amen, church? Hallelujah. Sige, mag-aral po tayo, no? We are going to be talking about prayer, but let's go deeper po. Amen. So bilang Kristiyano, alam natin na one of the most important tool or one of the most important tool sa ating armament in faith is prayer. Amen. And when we say prayer or praying, ano po yung ibig nating sabihin? Prayer or praying is napakalawak pong kataga sa buhay ng isang Kristiyano, mga kapatid. But in simple term, alam natin na prayer is communicating with God. Amen? So as a Christian, as a believer, prayer, my dear brothers and sisters, is our way of communicating with the Lord. Amen? In the same way with communication, there are verbal and non-verbal forms of communication. Amen po. Diyan po tayo magaling. Especially with people who work in the learning disability and profound learning disability, diyan tayo magaling that there are various kind of communication. Amen. And when we say communication, it involves telling something to God and listening from God. Amen. And when we say corporate or when we say agreement, my dear brothers and sisters, what do we mean by this one? When we say corporate and when we say agreement, that is the branch of prayer where the believers, where two or more people are gathering to pray together in the Lord. Amen. It is in that agreement or corporate praying na yung relasyon natin bilang isang Kristiyano sa bawat isa ay tumitibay, at ganun din sa relasyon natin bilang magkakasama ay tumitibay sa Panginoon. Amen po. In Matthew chapter 18, verses 19 to 20, it says in there, if two of you agree on earth about anything they ask, it will be done for them by my Father in heaven. For where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am in the midst of them. There I am among them. So yan po yung agreement prayer. Yan po yung corporate prayer. If two or more come together in prayer. Amen, church? But our topic today is intercession or intercessory prayer. What do we mean by intercession or intercessory prayer? Again, that is another branch of our prayer life, my dear brothers and sisters. To the drivers, when you are driving, when you start driving, Ate Grace, ang ka nag-uumpisa? When you start driving? First gear. Amen. When you are driving first gear. But with intercession, yun po yung when you change your gear to a higher gear. Amen po. So sa isang Kristiyano, kailangan po natin ito talaga para mag-mature is we need this intercessory prayer. Because again, sabi nga natin kung sa pagmamaneho, it's another gear, a gear higher po sa ating pananampalataya. Amen po, no? So the act of praying, no? Ano po ba yung intercession or intercessory prayer? This is the act of praying for other people. Amen. Kasi hindi na po yung prayer mo, my dear brothers and sisters, step outside more than para sa sarili mo. Amen? Amen. When we say intercessory prayer, my dear brothers and sisters, this is now the time when you pray for other people. In layman's term, my dear brothers and sisters, ito po yung tinatawag natin. If you are familiar with the word, kung naririnig nyo, let us stand in the gap. When you say, let us stand in the gap, because the person who you are praying is here, God is here, so you are standing in between them, bringing to God the prayer of this person to God. Amen po. So, mga kapatid, no? As a Christian, we are encouraged to pray. But sabi nga natin, as a Christian, it's another gear higher when we intercede. When our prayer is stopped for our desires for ourselves. For our prayer is stopped for the purpose of our personal benefit. But our prayer now becomes for other people. Amen, church? Our prayer now becomes standing in the gap between these people, between this family, between this church, between this group, between this nation, and the Lord. Amen po, church? Amen. Amen. Sa 1 Timothy chapter 2, verses 1 to 4, ito po yung instruction ng Panginoon. I urge then, first of all, that request prayers, intercessions. Diba? So makikita natin, sineparate po niya yung prayer and intercession. So hindi lang po tayo mag-pray for ourselves, but ganun din, let's intercede for the sake of others. Amen. I urge then, first of all, that requests, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgiving be made for everyone. For the kings, and for all in those in authority, that we may live peacefully and quietly in all godliness and holiness. This is good and pleases God our Savior, who wants all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. Amen, my dear brothers and sisters. So sometimes, this unrest that are happening, sometimes this disorder that is happening, sometimes it's an indication that there are not enough people interceding sa Panginoon. Malinaw yung sabi ng Panginoon that when people are interceding for presidents, for prime ministers, for leaders, for people who are in authority, ano yung sabi niya doon? We will live by peace. Amen, church. We will live by peace. Hindi pa po huli ang lahat, my dear brothers and sisters. Amen. With all the turmoil that is happening in the world right now, the Lord can still yet give peace. Amen. But we need to stand in the gap and start interceding. Amen, my dear brothers and sisters. That is the challenge of today. As a believer, as a Christian, as your family, for us to begin to learn that ministry, that gift of interceding. Amen. Kasi sabi niya rito, if we intercede, not only that we will live peacefully with one another, sabi niya rito, it pleases God. It pleases God, sabi niya rito sa verse 3. Mabuti ito, this is good, and it pleases God. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, if it pleases God, if your father who is pleased for you, give you everything in their own power and ability, how much more the Lord? Amen, church. How much more the Lord if we begin to please Him? If we begin to cause that smile in His lips, yung smile na yan, mag-overflow sa lahat sa atin. We will begin smiling. Amen, church. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Romans 8:26, sabi niya po rito, mga kapatid, no? Likewise, that the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know what to pray for as we ought, but the Spirit Himself intercedes for us with groanings which are too deep for words. Amen. So that's the reason why sometimes na, alam mo yung you are feeling down, you are feeling very low, na sometimes gusto mong humingi ng kapatawaran sa Panginoon, na sometimes gusto mong lumapit sa Panginoon, sometimes gusto mong mag-pray sa Panginoon, but you're feeling very low na, as if feeling mo hindi ka makalapit sa Panginoon. But sometimes, the Lord use a music, the Lord use a song, the Lord use a word, the Lord use a passage na nabasa mo, and all of a sudden, nandyan lang that there is that conviction and you are crying, my dear brothers and sisters, and you do not understand what is happening. Rest assured that the Bible says that that is the ministry of that Holy Spirit, that when you cannot come and pray to the Lord, when you feel so ashamed to come near the Lord, when you feel so guilty to come to the Lord, rest assured that the Holy Spirit is there interceding with you. The Holy Spirit is there standing in the gap between you and the Father. Amen, church. Because remember, in the principle of praying, sa Ama po tayo nagdadasal. It is nowhere in the Bible that says, let us pray to the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to Jesus. In the principle of praying, sabi niya rito, sa Ama tayo magdadasal. By all means, yung dasal natin para maging effective, ipadaan natin kay Jesucristo. Amen, church? That is the principle of praying. Pero yung prayer natin is to the Father. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Romans 8:34, who is seated at the right hand of God, standing in the gap between us and the Father? Jesus. Jesus is interceding for us. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, the Holy Spirit in Jesus is our greatest intercessors. Amen. But having been saved, having received the Lord Jesus, nagamit muli nung Friday ni Ate Grace, Galatians 2:20. It is no longer us that live, but Christ lives in us. Nagamit muli, sabi ni Ate Annie, ginamit niya yung John chapter 7, that when we received the Lord Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit was given to us. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, kung ang Holy Spirit is the greatest intercessor, if Jesus is the greatest intercessor, and Jesus is with us, and the Holy Spirit is with us, what makes us become? We need to strive to be an intercessor. Amen, church? Amen? Someone who is practicing or engaged in intercession are called intercessors. Thank you very much. Amen. And when we are interceding, just like in any other prayer, my dear brothers and sisters, we do not need to be righteous. We do not need to be righteous in order to intercede, in order to stand in the gap. Isn't it when you pray to the Lord, you do not need to be righteous to pray to the Lord? Amen. But there is always that very point in our prayer that we make our right standing with God. That's the reason why we always begin our prayer with sanctification, pagpapalinis, paghingi ng kapatawaran. Amen po. The Lord is not a cash machine na pagpunta natin is, Lord, I need your blessing. I want your blessing. Hindi po, mga kapatid. Inasmuch as we do not need to be righteous, inasmuch as we do not need to be holy, to be able to pray, to be able to intercede, to be able to stand in the gap. But the Bible clearly says that the fervent prayer of a righteous person is powerful and effective. Amen. James 5:16. The prayer of the righteous person is powerful and effective. Amen po. And what qualifies our righteousness? Again, napag-usapan natin nung Friday. What qualifies our righteousness? It is not by our work. It is not the things that we do. But our righteousness is in the Lord. Amen? That's the reason why, para maging powerful and effective yung prayer natin, we need to be in the eyes of the Lord righteous. By virtue of what? Starting with your sanctification in prayer. Amen. Starting in sanctification when we pray. Amen, church? In Ephesians chapter 4, verses 11 to 12, it talks about the fivefold ministry. So Christ himself gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the pastors, and the teachers for the purpose of equipping his people for works of services, for building up the body of Christ. Amen. So when we talk about Ephesians chapter 4, we talk about the fivefold ministry. And my dear brothers and sisters, alam natin dito that not everyone are called to be within the fivefold ministry. Hindi po lahat magiging apostle, hindi po lahat magiging prophet, hindi po lahat magiging evangelist, hindi po lahat magiging pastor, hindi po lahat magiging teacher, my dear brothers and sisters. That is a special separate calling within the ministry. But intercession is a ministry that is available for everybody. Amen. Intercession is a ministry that the Lord wants everyone to be involved with. Gusto ng Panginoon na maging kabahagi po ang kanyang katawan sa intercession, my dear brothers and sisters. Whether you are the least or great in the kingdom, whether you convert yesterday or you have been a Christian for the last 70 years, my dear brothers and sisters, you have a part, you have a portion in the ministry of intercession. Amen, church? As a church, no? Señor, do we consider ourselves a church? Amen, no? As a church, or we called the body of Christ. Amen. That's what a church is called, the body of Christ. We are God's instrument here on earth for that ministry of intercession. Amen. Kasi we represent Christ eh. If Christ is the greatest intercessor and we are endowed by the power of another great intercessor, which is the Holy Spirit, that means, my dear brothers and sisters, that as a church, as a believer, my dear brothers and sisters, we ought to be championing the ministry of intercession, praying for others, standing in the gap for others. Amen po. The Church of the Lord, my dear brothers and sisters, is the extension, the manifestation of God's kingdom dito sa mundong ito. Amen po. And as a believer, as a Christian, our one of our title is we are called intercessors. Amen. You are called intercessor. Hindi lang po Kristiyano ang tawag sa atin, but you are also called intercessor because Christian, di ba, follower of Jesus Christ. So if Jesus ministry is intercession, so we ought to have that ministry of intercession as well. When Jesus was here on earth, he never prayed for himself. He seldom prayed for himself. Most of the time, he is praying for us. He is praying for us. Amen, church. And sabi nga natin, as a Christian, siyor, as a church. Because intercession is a work, is a ministry of believer, is a Christian, is a ministry of the church. So tayo as a Christian, we need to be intercessors. We as a church, we need to be intercessors. Amen. As a leaders, as a part of the ministry, we need to champion intercession. Amen. As a church, hindi naman pwedeng yung membro ang kakapapasok kahapon, mas intercessor siya kaysa sa ating nandito na ng ilang taon. Would that make sense, my dear brothers and sisters? Amen po. Hindi naman po pwedeng papasok ka sa isang eskwelahan. Yung grade 1, bigla niyang lilikturan yung kanyang propisok. Hindi po baliktad ang mundo ng Panginoon. Amen, church. You know, when we look at Exodus chapter 17, verses 18 to 13, this is a story sounds familiar. This is the time when Joshua and the people of Israelite is battling against another nation. And Moses was standing on top of the hill, interceding for them, lifted up his hands. That story now is becoming familiar, di ba? That Moses, from daytime to the night time, Moses is interceding, his hands are lifted. Amen. And as long as the hands of Moses is lifted, the Israelites are winning. But because Moses getting tired as well, bumababa po yung kanyang kamay. Pag bumababa yung kanyang kamay, natatalo ang Israelites. So what did Aaron and Hur do? Si Hur, no? H-U-R. Tumayo sila on either side of Moses and itinaas nila yung kamay ni Moses. Amen. That is a perfect example of intercession. Amen, church. Moses is standing in the gap between the people of Israel and the Lord, and they are winning. But when Moses gets tired, they are losing. And that's the time when the other leaders, that's the time when the intercessory, that's the time where, ano yung sabi natin kanina, the corporate intercession, agreement intercession came when Aaron and Hur came and intercede with Moses. Amen. And look at that. Tingnan natin yung pattern ng intercession doon. Sometimes, you know, when we intercede, di ba, katulad ng worship, there is should be order. Diba, when we come and worship, sabi ni Paul, there should be order. But sometimes this is what happened when we intercede. Inumpisahan ng isa nag-speaking in tongues, 100 miles per hour. Sinabayan nung isa 200 miles per hour. Sinabayan nung isa 300 miles per hour. Naggagano no. Diba, sabi ng ano dun, there should be order, maghintayan. Even in intercession, you know, the fact na nandun ka na, amen. Amen, Lord. That's the reason why when you are praying, my dear brothers and sisters, this is the secret to be counted. Ang dami nating nagdadasal, but sometimes our presence is not counted. Because if you want to be your presence to be counted and your presence in prayer is to be counted in the book of the Lord, when we are praying, say amen. Hindi man ikaw ang nagsasalita, but when you say amen, Lord, Opo Panginoon, siya nawa Panginoon, that word became your word. That prayer became your prayer. Amen. Katulad ni Moses, na si Aaron at saka si Hur, hindi man yung kamay nila ang itinataas, but by supporting that hand, they became a partaker of that intercession. Amen, church. Hallelujah. So that's an amazing example in power of intercession. Amen? So my dear brothers and sisters, there is power in intercession. There is power in being an intercessor. Amen, church? How many of us in here are interested to put a hand on that power? Amen? Declaration of faith. How many of us in here wants to acquire that power that the Lord gave to the intercessor? Anyone, church? Are you willing? Are you willing? Hallelujah. Declaration of faith. If you are willing, show a sign of willingness that say, Lord, I am willing. I am willing. Hallelujah. My dear brothers and sisters, there is a power in being an intercessor. And pay attention to this, because if you learn about this power, I'm sure if you are really committed and serious in the work of the Lord, hindi mo hihindian. Hindi mo tatanggihan. Hindi mo hindi tatanggapin. Amen, church. Number one, sabi niya rito, intercession is a seed. Intercession is a seed. Buto na itinatanim. Amen? Intercession is a seed. And kailangan nating understand, maintindihan, my dear brothers and sisters, that in the Bible, in the book of Deuteronomy, there is a law regarding seed time and harvest time. Amen? To be honest, that law, we acquire it in the Philippines. Kung may itinanim, may aanihin. Tama po yan. That is very biblical. When we intercede, we are planting a seed. And my dear brothers and sisters, according to the law of seed time and harvest, kung may itinanim, may aanihin. And every time that we engage in the ministry of intercession, sabi nga natin, we are planting a seed. We are sowing a seed. And based on that integrity of the law, kung may itinanim, may aanihin. Based on that integrity of the law, my dear brothers and sisters, when we sow seed in intercession, a harvest is coming. Amen? A harvest is coming. In Job chapter 42 verse 10, sabi niya rito, pay attention to this passage. Job 42 verse 10, it says in there, and the Lord turned the captivity of Job. When? Kailan? The Lord turned the captivity of Job. Ano yung captivity of Job na tinatawag na to? Sa story of Job. What does this mean? this captivity of Job. Alam naman natin kung ano yung nangyari kay Job, di po ba? Amen? Job nagkasakit. Job namatay ang kanyang mga pamilya, walang natira sa kanya. Job nawala lahat yung kanyang ari-arian. Job nagkasakit siya ng sakit na walang kalunasan. Iniwan siya ng kanyang mga kaibigan. Iniwan siya ng kanyang mga kapitbahay. Alam niyo kung ano na lang ang natitira kay Job, anyone? His faith. His life. Yun na lamang po yung natitira kay Job during that time. Yung kanyang buhay. Yung kanyang pananampalataya sa Panginoon. And in Job chapter 42 verse 10, it says in there, the Lord turned the captivity of Job when he prayed for his friends. And the Lord gave Job twice as much as he had. Amen, church. So when we intercede, it is the law of seed time and harvest. When we intercede, we are planting seed. And we know that if we plant seed, kung may itinanim, may aanihin, a harvest is coming. Amen. In the beginning of the story of Job, if you read the Job, in the beginning of his story, nung nagkasakit siya, ang dami niyang tanong sa Panginoon. Panginoon, bakit ganito ang nangyayari sa akin? Bakit ako nagkasakit? Bakit nangamatay ang aking pamilya? Bakit nangawala ang aking ari-arian? In the beginning of the affliction of Job, walang ginawa si Job kundi ipagdasal ang kanyang sarili. Iniyak niya ang kanyang sarili sa Panginoon. Ipinagdasal niya ang kanyang sarili sa Panginoon. Ipinagdasal niya ang kanyang karamdaman sa Panginoon. Ipinagdasal niya ang kanyang problema sa Panginoon. Ipinagdasal niya ang kanyang sitwasyon sa Panginoon. But clearly, walang nangyayari. Clearly, hindi siya gumagaling. Clearly, hindi bumubuti ang kanyang kalagayan, mga kapatid. Amen? And it comes to a point where Job, sabi ni Job, almost inaccept niya na ang kanyang kapalaran. Inaccept niya na ang kanyang kinahahantungan. Sabi ni Job, wala na akong magagawa kung hindi tanggapin ang aking kapalaran. Wala na akong magagawa kung hindi tanggapin ang plano ng Panginoon sa aking buhay. People who have issues, people na mayroong kayong pinagdadaanan, especially historical yung pinagdadaanan ninyo na yan. And sometimes sasabihin natin na the Lord answer prayer by yes, not yet, and no. And probably sabi natin, siguro sabi ng Panginoon, the answer of the Lord is no. But you know what? You begin sowing seed. You begin to pray for others. Because sabi ng Panginoon, the captivity of Job, my dear brothers and sisters, was turned around when he began to stand in the gap between his friends in the Lord. Amen. Nung itinigil ni Job ang pagdadasal sa kanyang sarili, ipinagdasal na lang niya yung ibang tao. Amen, church. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. If you have prayed enough for your situation and hindi sinasagot ng Panginoon, it's about time to pray for others. And just like Job, the Lord said, when Job begin to pray for others, when you begin to pray for others, I'm gonna turn your captivity around. I will not only restore you, but I will restore you twofolds. Doble. Amen, church. Hallelujah. So my dear brothers and sisters, family is your. Let God begin to turn your captivity. Let God begin to turn your problem, your issues, your desire, your cry by praying for others. Amen? Every serious intercessor should have a list. If you are a serious intercessor, kaya nga tayo nag-gather ng prayer list. Magkaroon tayo ng listahan na ipinagdadasal, Kasi kung wala kang listahan, alam mo, sarili mo lang yung ipinagdadasal mo. And as a serious intercessor, magkaroon tayo ng listahan, mga kapatid, ng mga tao, ng mga sitwasyon, ng mga pagkakataon, ng mga lahat, to pray to the Lord and challenge the Lord. If you do that, the Lord will turn to begin your captivity around. Amen. Alam ko na may mga iba sa atin na may mga imposibleng pinagdadaanan, and it could be na tinanggap nyo na yan yung kapalaran ng Panginoon, katulad ni Job. I challenge us. I urge us. Hindi lang sila, mga kapatid. Tayong lahat. Especially kung alam natin yung sitwasyon, let's begin to pray for that situation. Let's begin to pray for that situation. And the Lord will turn around those captivity. Amen po, church? Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. No? Lahat po tayong Kristiyano should have that sincere heart of intercession. Amen? Let me tell you this. This is a testimony. And I'm sure that probably more people, some of you are probably more than me, some of you are probably catching up, and I encourage you to increase. My dear brothers and sisters, hindi naman po to in pagbubos, but every time that I pray to the Lord, more than 80% of my prayer, or even ask Mary and ask the children, every time that we are praying, more than 80% of our prayer is not for us. It is for others. It is not because I am the pastor of the church. It is not because as a pastor family, it's not because as a spiritual, no, hindi po. But that is an act of love. That is an act of commitment, mga kapatid. Amen. And if you are more than there, my dear brothers and sisters, I urge you to continue. And if you are catching up, there is still a lot of room to grow. Amen po, mga kapatid. Amen. We need to be an intercessor. We need to have that earnest desire to intercede. And with this, again, I gave that invitation. I extend that invitation. That as the pastor, as the spiritual father of this church, I want to know what is happening with you. Hindi para alam ko. But so that I may pray with you and for you. I want to know, I am interested to know what is happening. You know, ang nangyayari, ang culture sa church ganito. It is not necessarily, hindi ko sinasabing negative, but our culture in the church is, patawanin ko kayo. Our culture in the church is, kung meron tayong gustong prayer, kung meron tayong gustong ipagdasal, kung meron tayong gustong ipag-intercede, we just drop a message in the chat group. And the pastor is the last person to know na may pinagdadaanan ka pala, na may kailangan ka pala, na meron ka palang kailangan. And we drop a message in the chat group. That's not necessarily wrong, ha? Sabi ko, we encourage that because in the chat group, members of people in there are the body of Christ. Tayo po yun. Amen po. We drop an intercession in there, and this is what happens. Once a prayer is dropped in there, ping, 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 ping. Ang daming mga ano dun, na mga declaration, na maraming verses na, and those verses are biblical, scriptural, nandun, ping, 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 ping. Amen. But my question is, how many of those people have actually taken that prayer? How many of those people actually brought that prayer and come to God at night and cry to God at night and stand to God that night in your behalf? I'm not lying. More than 3/4 of those people, by 10 o'clock, they are already snoring and sleeping. By 11 o'clock, they're already sleeping and snoring. How many of those people have actually took those prayer and cannot sleep without giving to the Lord that prayer, without interceding to the Lord, without standing in the gap between you and the Lord? My dear brothers and sisters, no? So as invitation, my dear brothers and sisters, you don't need No. We are all human being. Amen. And I don't need, as a human being, I don't need your kumbaga, kung yung kasiyahan, kagalakan, yeah, it's okay. I don't mind privy to that. But what is happening in you spiritually, doon po yung operation natin eh. Di po ba? Amen. Kung yun po yung operation natin. So, I encourage you. I encourage you. I really want to know what is happening with you so that I can pray. Nasubukan nyo na ba, mga kapatid, na meron kang iniyak sa Panginoon isang gabi? Lord, Lord, para magising ka kinabukasan, yung palang iniiyak mo sa Panginoon dalawang araw ng patay. Diba? Diba? Meron kang iniiyak sa Panginoon, ibinigay yung prayer request ng Monday, and you continue to pray in an attitude of prayer Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. You are pressing on. Pinagpa-fast mo, pinag-pre-pray mo. By Friday comes, pinag-pre-pray mo. Yung pala, Wednesday palang patay na yung pinag-pre-pray mo. Nagamit mo sana yung ano na yun para sa iba. So my dear brothers and sisters, let us be an intercessor. Amen po? Praise you, Jesus. Sabi nga natin, intercession is a seed. And kung gusto natin magtanim, kailangan natin magtanim. Okay, sige, bilisan na po natin. Intercession, mga kapatid, kung gusto natin, if we want to have access to the plan of the Lord, ilan po sa atin dito yung gusto nating malaman kung ano yung nasa sa loobin ng Panginoon? Ilan po sa atin dito yung gustong malaman kung ano yung plano ng Panginoon? Amen? Diba, pag nagdadasal tayo sa Panginoon, Lord, ipakita mo sa akin yung plano mo. But being an intercessor, my dear brothers and sisters, meron tayong access sa plano ng Panginoon? Amen? Meron tayong access sa plano ng Panginoon? Amen? Meron tayong access sa secret ng Panginoon? Amen? My dear brothers and sisters, when you open your heart, kung binuksan natin yung ating puso in the ministry of intercession, God can trust you. How many of us in here na pagkatiwalaan tayo ng Panginoon? Ilan po sa atin dito na sabihin natin na ang Panginoon nagtitiwala sa akin? Anyone? In order for us na pagkatiwalaan ng Panginoon, let us be an intercessor. Amen? When you open your heart to the desire and the commitment of intercession, God can trust you. You know, a lot of people in the body of Christ claim that they have a gift of prophecy. May pinapakita sa kanila ang Panginoon. A lot of people claim that they have the gift of discernment. Pinapakita ng Panginoon sa kanila kung ano yung totoo. They have the gift of revelation. Pinapakita sa kanila ng Panginoon kung ano ang nangyayari. So may ipinapakita ang Panginoon. Amen? And that is very real. Sometimes the Lord can open your spiritual senses. The Lord will open your spiritual senses and show you about a person, will show you about a family, will show you about the situation in the church, will show you about the situation in work, will show you about the situation of your neighbor, my dear brothers and sisters. But you know why the Lord is giving that to you? Why the Lord is showing that to you? Is it because you are just simply special in the eyes of the Lord at pinili ka niyang ipakita yan sa'yo at hindi sa iba? The reason, my dear brothers and sisters, is pinagkakatiwalaan ka ng Panginoon to pray for it. Pinagkakatiwalaan ka ng Panginoon to do something for it. The Lord entrusts that revelation to you, discernment, that prophetic to you, so that you can pray for it. Amen? Hindi para ikwento, hindi para ichism. Well, kung yung pinagsasabihan mo ay mag-i-intercede din, eh bakit hindi? Hindi para to draw our own judgment in conclusion. Have you ever encountered, I heard people say about this, the Lord revealed a secret to them and they have not done anything for it. And before they know it, bakit kaya wala nang dumarating? Bakit kaya wala nang revelation? Dati, tuloy-tuloy. Dati yung revelation, dati yung pinapakita ng Panginoon sa akin, tuloy-tuloy. Bakit kaya parang nag-dry? Because you have not been trustable enough. You have not been praying for it. Amen, church? The reason that God has entrusted those secrets of the heaven to you is for you to intercede for them. Amen, church? In Genesis chapter 18, verses 17 to 18, it says in here, this is the time when God decided to destroy the city of Sodom and Gomorrah. Amen. Ano yung sabi ni God? The Lord said, shall I hide from Abraham what I am about to do? Amen. Shall I keep a secret to Abraham? Hindi. Sasabihin ko kay Abraham. And the Lord told to Abraham what was his plan. And ano yung ginawa ni Abraham? Abraham interceded to the Lord. Amen. Di po ba nakipag-intercede siya sa Panginoon? Di po ba nag-pray siya sa Panginoon? But this is what I want us to see. This is the revelation of the Lord. This is the rema of the word. Sabi niya rito, shall I hide from Abraham what I am about to do? Tignan natin. Abraham will surely become a great and powerful nation, and all nations on earth will be blessed through him. Ano po yung naintindihan natin doon, mga kapatid? The Lord is saying that I am going to bless Abraham. He will become a great nation. The Lord is saying that whatever I will do to Abraham, it will be for other people. That's the reason why Abraham will become a great nation. But because through that great nation, many nations will be blessed. Amen. How many of us in here gain the trust of the Lord? That the Lord saying that whatever it is that I will do to you, I know that you will do justice. Amen. If I will give you a wealth, I know that you will sell that wealth and give it to the poor. Amen, church. If I will give you a possession, I know that you will sell that possession to give it to the poor. So let us be trustable, my dear brothers and sisters. Amen? The Lord loves us all equally. Amen, church? Do we know that? Do you know that you, a believer, Zeb, and the Pope, the Lord loves them equally? Oh, see? The Lord loves us all equally. Amen? But the Lord does not trust us equally. Equal po ang pagmamahal ng Panginoon sa ating lahat, pero hindi equal ang tiwala ng Panginoon sa ating lahat. Kung titignan natin yung parable of the talents, Matthew 25, the Lord gave to one 5 talents, the Lord gave to one 2 talents, the Lord gave to one 1 talent as a measure of his trust to them. Amen. Kaya nga sabi ng Panginoon, to them who are trusted much, much will be given. Amen. Ano? We are praying for revival. Lord, we want revival. Amen, church. Paanong magdadala ang Panginoon ng 50 more souls kung yung kapasidad ng pananampalataya natin para lang sa mga 20 na katao? That's the reason why revival starts in us. Amen. Kawawa naman yung mga taong ipadadala ng Panginoon kung pagdating nila, eh hindi rin natin sila maia-usher, maiga-guide. Amen. A blind man cannot lead a blind, sabi niya rito. So my dear brothers and sisters, will you be trustworthy and committed intercessor that God can reveal His secrets to you? Amen, church? There is an invitation to the pulpit. Will you be a committed intercessor that God can show His secrets to you? Anyone? There's an army rising up. Declaration, come on, church. There's an army rising up. There's an army rising up. Nasaan yung army, mga kapatid? Declaration of faith. Come on, for once, for the first time in history of yore, the pastor led the congregation in worship. Come on, church. There's an army rising up. If you want to be an intercessor, declare, there's an army rising up. And I am part of that army, Lord. There's an army rising up. And we will break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. Hallelujah. Amen, church. Hallelujah. Papuri sa iyo, Panginoon. Thank you. Because you are building up an army. You are building up an army. And I am one of them. Amen. I am one of them. Amen, church. Amen. The final is, if the Lord build up an army, if you are an army, where is your office? In the battlefield. Amen. If you are an army, where is your office? In the battlefield. Amen. And if you are an army in the battlefield, my dear brothers and sisters, ano ang kailangan mo? Full armor. Kailangan mo yung full force, yung full power. Kailangan mo ng baril, kailangan mo ng ammunition. That's what Zelensky has been crying. Give us this. Don't give me a plane to go out. Give me this. Amen, church. Aside from planting seed, aside from receiving the secret of the Lord, my dear brothers and sisters, there is an authority for being an intercessor. There is a general authority given to all the Christians. Mark 16:17, sabi niya rito, these are the signs will accompany those who believe. Ito sa mga mananampalataya, meron kang kapangyarihan na binigay ng Panginoon. In my name, they will cast out demons. They will speak in tongues. They will pick up serpent with their hands. And if they drink deadly poison, it will not hurt them. They will lay their hands on the sick and they will recover. Amen. Is anyone sick among you? Come on, you have the power and authority that the Lord gave you. Lay your hands upon that part of your body. Ano man yung karamdaman mo right here, right now. Lay your hands on that part of that body by the virtue and power of the declaration of the Lord that you have the power. Ano man po yung gusto mong mangyari, ano man yung gusto mong mabuksan dyan na nakasarado, come on, lay your hands. There is power in intercession and I stand in the gap with you and with the Lord. Let's do it, my dear brothers and sisters. Lay it, put your hands upon those. Put your hands upon it in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Mga kapatid, bukod dyan sa general authority na ibinigay ng Panginoon sa mga Kristiyano, there is that special power in authority na binigay ng Panginoon sa mga intercessor. Amen. In Daniel chapter 4 verse 7, it says in here, if we read this, sabi niya rito, this is the time when King Nebuchadnezzar was turned to be a beast. Alam po natin yung storya na yun. That King Nebuchadnezzar did not humble himself to the Lord. King Nebuchadnezzar did not humble himself to the servant of God, and hindi siya nag-humble sa Panginoon. And ano yung nangyari? He put himself above the Lord. So the Lord cursed Nebuchadnezzar. Amen. But eto po yung gusto kong pakinggan natin. Daniel chapter 4 verse 7. This matter meaning, my dear brothers and sisters, this matter, anong version yan, Brad? 4:17. Yeah, King James, if you can stay in King James, that's very good. Sabi niya rito, mga kapatid, this matter, ano po yung matter na pinag-uusapan dun? That's the turning of King Nebuchadnezzar to become a beast. This matter is by the decree of the watchers, sabi niya rito. And the demand by the word of the Holy One, to the intent that the living may know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of man and giveth it to whomsoever he will, and seateth up over to the bestest of men. Mga kapatid, kung maintindihan natin, kung naiintindihan natin ang scripture na to, mga kapatid, hindi lang po ang Panginoon. It was not just God who judged King Nebuchadnezzar. There are watchmen. May mga watchmen po doon. And the Lord called us to be watchmen for one another. Diba? The Lord called us to be a watchman of our brethren. By being a watchman to our brethren, what does it mean? Yun ba yung sinisilip mo kung ano yung pagkakamali niya? Yun ba yung sinisilip mo kung ano yung sikreto niya? Watchman meaning, you pray for them. You intercede for them. Amen. And sabi niya rito, this matter is by the decree of the watchmen. So hindi lang po, mga kapatid, it is not just God who judged King Nebuchadnezzar. Also, those people who were interceding, there were men and women who were interceding for the evil scheme of King Nebuchadnezzar. They were praying that enough, enough. Your sin is enough. Yung kapalaluhan mo is enough. And the Lord honored that demand. The Lord honored that demand. Amen. That is the reason why that the word of the Lord, there is the tongue has the power to declare blessing in a curse. Amen. The tongue has the power to intercede for blessing in a curse. Pero dapat bilang isang Kristiyano, blessing lang po ang lumalabas sa ating mga bibig. Kasi sabi niya, whatever the content of our heart, it overflows in our mouth. So dapat blessing lang ang binibitawan ng ating mga bunganga. Blessing lang ang binibitawan ng ating mga bunganga. Because once you release a curse, it will corrupt your heart. If your faith is corrupted, come to the Lord, and the Lord can restore that faith. But if your heart is corrupted, you needed a new heart. Kailangan kang magkaroon ng surgery spiritually to have a new heart. Amen, church. Praise you, Jesus. There is power in intercession, mga kapatid. There is power in being an intercessor. And I know na itong tatlong sinabi natin, planting seed, receiving the secret of the Lord, authority and power, mga kapatid, ilan lamang po ito. As you go and read your Bible, and I encourage you to go home and read your Bible, as you go and read your Bible, I desire, I pray that the Lord will give you more revelations pertinent to our message today, my dear brothers and sisters. Amen. And I pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that the Lord will have a personal dealing with us. Meanwhile, ang dasal ko po sa bawat isa sa atin. Ang dasal ko po para sa ating minamahal na iglesia, the Sior, Christ is our Rock Church Ministries International, mga kapatid. Especially sa panahong ito, nasabi nga ni Ate Grace noong Friday, there is a great compromise in the church. There is a great compromise in the church. Na sometimes wala nang trustworthy, sometimes wala nang committed intercessor. My prayer, my dear brothers and sisters, that the Lord will open our heart. That the Lord will give us that deep and trustworthy desire, longing to intercede, mga kapatid. Marami pong opportunities. Marami pong opportunities. Tayo lamang po yung hindi nagra-grab ng opportunities. Women, you have your Wednesday meeting to be there and intercede. Leaders, we have our alternate Tuesday and Thursdays to be there and intercede. Church, we have our after Friday fellowship to be there in intercede. Music, you have your Saturday practice, hindi lang kapain, kundi to be there in intercede. And we do not just come to church just to sing songs, to say line, to sit down. My dear brothers and sisters, you know the secret of revival? Ngayon alam ko na. You know the secret of revival? You know for these chairs to be filled? Gusto nyong mapuno ang mga upuang ito? You want to take over this whole building because the Lord gave that whole building to accommodate to us? Alam nyo po kung ano yung secret? You don't just come to church and sing. You don't just come to church and pray. My dear brothers and sisters, be an intercessor. You might not be the one standing in front, but as you are standing in there praising and worshiping, actively praising and worshiping, but deep inside you are interceding. Amen. As you are seated in there, especially in the time where yung message napapahaba na, but if you're seated in there in interceding, mga kapatid, there will be revival. The Lord, hindi pwedeng i-withhold ng Panginoon ng revival. Let us be an intercessor. To be honest, yan po yung ginagawa ko. I might be there standing, jumping, praising the Lord, but deep inside my heart, I am interceding for all the people who were leading the praise and worship. And in even those times, Friday Bible study na, hindi po ako yung nagsishare, I am there. Even during the time na I'm actively involved, pag si Ate Annie yung nagsishare na, ako yung nagmaman up ng line, I am in there praying and interceding. You know, ginamit ka ng Panginoon na tumayo rito and deliverance is happening, people are crying, you are used by the Lord here to preach and deliverance, movement of the Holy Spirit is crying. You know, it's not your own benefit to tell you there are people na bago mo pa man inumpisahang iprepara ang mensahe mo, may mga tao nang nagdadasal para sa'yo. bago mo pa man hiningi yung line-up mo, may mga tao nang nagdadasal para dyan. Hindi man dito, even yung mga magulang nyo, yung mga ibang tao, hindi ka pa man naka-allocate, may nag-pre-pray na para dyan. Amen. The principle of the Lord is sowing. Hindi lamang po magdasal tayo ng Saturday and Lord give us a powerful and wonderful praise and worship tomorrow and boom. Hindi mo na itatanong, may tahimik pala dun sa dulo na last week palang nagdadasal na. Last week palang iniiiyak na. Amen, church. Let us stand up. Let us call the music team po. Alam ko po mga kapatid, the reality is, it's madaling sabihin, but the reality mga kapatid is, there are many challenges in the ministry of intercession. There is the challenge of the flesh. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Mga kapatid, no? Sabi ko nga, marami pong obstacle, marami pong challenges sa ministry ng intercession. Nandyan po yung ating flesh, nandyan yung schemes of the enemy. Your body will say it is too early. Your body will say it is too late. Your body will say you are too tired. Your body will say you are not feeling well. Your body will say you are alone. Bakit ka pupunta doon sa alas 10 ng umaga? Mag-isa ka lang, wag. Magpa-late ka ng konti para may makasama ka. The enemy will fight you. Because you know what? The enemy knows the power of prayer. The enemy knows the power of intercession. Yung lahat ng bagay na sinabi natin ngayon, alam ng kalaban yan. And to be honest, the enemy tried to stop that message in being preached for us today. But there will always be the Lord's time, my dear brothers and sisters. So my dear brothers and sisters, be strong. Be filled with the Holy Spirit. He is our great intercessor. Let us resist the scheme of the enemy and let us press on. In our season of revival, we look at the church and say, Lord, what can I do? Lord, what can we do for your church? Tingnan natin yung nangyayari sa mundo ngayon. Lord, what can I do? Lord, what can we contribute to everything that is happening in the world right now? But today, the Lord answered that question. Today, the Lord has revealed the answer. Things will radically change when we all get engaged in the ministry of intercession. And I challenge everyone right here, right now, as we have declared amen, as we have raised our hands earlier, our desire and intention to be a part of that ministry of intercession. To receive that ministry of intercession by faith. Let God use you to do the extraordinary for His glory and praise. Sige, let us desire as the music lead us and usher us in praise and worship. Let us desire, hilingin natin sa Panginoon. The Lord said, whatever, the Lord said, ask anything in my name and it shall be given you. My dear brothers and sisters, if there is one thing and only one thing that I want to ask the Lord today, is that is for the Lord to give me that earnest, that trustworthy, that committed desire to be a partaker of the ministry of intercession. Welcome the Lord, church, with open hearts. The Lord can only come if He is welcome in your life.
Change my heart, I pray. Steer my heart again to pray. Blessed Holy Spirit.
Lord, I want to have the passion to intercede for other people.
Set my heart on fire.
my family. Intercede for my neighbor. Intercede for my calling.
Draw nearer.
Come on, church, ask God to give you that spirit, that desire to be a partaker of that ministry of intercession. If you have been an intercessor before, and if you have stepped backwards, ask the Lord to rekindle that fire in you. Ask the Lord to rekindle that passion to intercede, to stand in the gap for others, to stand in the gap between this and the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, there is power in the life of being an intercessor. And it is my prayer that the Lord give you that grace to sustain that spirit of intercession, to come and pray and intercede to the Lord without ceasing every day. My dear brothers and sisters, your family, your husband, your wife, your children, this church, your brothers and sisters, your leaders, your pastor, your community, your president, the prime minister, the queen, countries and nations are desperately in need of intercessors. Will you take the challenge? Will you step up and receive the calling of the Lord? There is a special calling. Receive. There is a special calling in the ministry of intercession. My dear brothers and sisters, the song says, ignite my fire. The song says, let my heart on fire. And how many of us in here right now that the Lord letting those hearts on fire? Amen? If the Lord is setting up your heart on fire, declare amen. Amen, amen, amen. But the Lord says, it demands decision and action from us. Let me draw near to you. The Lord says, Lord, it is not enough that you have given my heart on fire. It is not enough that you have given me the conviction. It is not enough, Lord, that I am feeling you right now. What the desire of the Lord is for us to draw to Him closer. Take that step forward and affirm your commitment. Take that step forward and affirm your commitment and promise to the Lord. Lord, I am not promising to this pastor. I am not promising to this church. I am not promising to these people. I am promising to you, Lord. As you have bought my heart, as you have set my heart on fire, Lord, I am taking that step to come to you closer, to be an intercessor. Lord, your calling demands action. Your calling demands action. And Father, help me find my way to you. My dear brothers and sisters, wala pong pilitan. Both people in the foyer and ministers at the back, if the Lord has set your heart on fire once again and you have taken the decision to take that step forward to be an intercessor, let us affirm our commitment to the Lord, that trustworthy commitment. Let us affirm that commitment by raising our hands and say, Lord, I want to be counted. Come on, raise hands. If the Lord is calling you to be an intercessor, if the Lord is calling you to be an intercessor, if the Lord is calling you to pray for others, if the Lord is calling you to stand in the gap, raise those hands. Be counted. Be counted. Be counted. Raise those hands, church. Be counted. It is not the virtue of the word of the pastor. The Lord is here. The Lord is here. The Lord is here. Where two or three are gathered in His name, He is in the midst of them. We are doing this to the Lord. Lord, we are doing this for you. This commitment is to you, Father. This commitment is for you, Father God. Lord, set my heart on fire. Set my heart on fire, Lord. Rekindle my desire to pray for others. Rekindle my desire to stand in the gap, Father God. Lord, I might not understand things, but I know you have a calling for me. I might not understand it yet, but I know you are setting my heart on fire. And therefore, I am taking that leap of faith to come to you in Jesus' name right now. In Jesus' name right now. Father, thank you for the powerful weapon of prayer made available for all the believers, made available for my brothers and sisters who have affirmed their trustworthy commitment to you. We praise you, Lord, for your faithfulness. We praise you for the beauty of your holiness. Come on, church, let us worship the Lord. But this time, we are going to worship the Lord as an intercessor. Hallelujah!
Panginoon, mati. Pag may prayer, luhod agad. Dahil bakit? Yun yung nagiging source. Bakit ka mag-pray? Kasi on fire ka, in love ka sa Lord eh. Amen? But may gusto pong ibigay na word from the Lord. I'm so blessed sa teaching ko ngayon ng Panginoon kasi some of those words na binanggit ni Pastor ay devotion ko today. Marami pong confirmation ng Lord for me today. Na yung tanong din eh, kanina ni Pastor, sorry po ha, malakas lang yung conviction ko. Yung kanina binanggit ni Pastor, nung time na ako ay napaka-alab ko sa prayer. May isang tao po ako na alas tres ng madaling araw, bigla akong ginising ni Lord, may pinlash out siya sa aking mukha. You need to pray for this person. Nalaman ko kinabukasan, nag-aagaw buhay pala yung taong yun. Dinala sa hospital. Tingnan niyo kung gaano po. Yun yung desire ng puso ko na yung sabi ni Pastor kanina kasi inintrust ka ni Lord sa ganito pero dahil hindi mo nagagawa, pwedeng hindi ka na ulit pagkatiwalaan. Pero ngayon ito po yun, binigyan tayo muli ng message ni Lord. I-desire natin na tayo po ang daluyan ng pagpapala o tayo po ang daluyan ng Lord sa kanyang mensahe o doon sa mga taong gusto niyang ipag-pray natin sa kanya. Amen po. At last the word po, sabi ni Lord, you did not choose me, but I choose you.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Once again, can we just give a clap of praise as we sing this to God? Hallelujah! Kahit manghina ka, hindi dahilan para tumigil, para manalangin. Praise God! Hallelujah! We give back all the glory to the Lord as we sing this song. Hallelujah!
Remain in the attitude of worship. Let us just close our service today. Hallelujah. Lord, after all po ng ginawa mo, with everything that you have done, Father God, Lord, we gave you glory, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
We gave you glory, Father God. Maraming salamat, Lord, that you have allowed us
this experience, this encounter, this moment with you, Father God. Lord, we thank you because you have chosen us to be your dwelling today, Father God. And Lord, we gave you glory, Father God. We cannot thank you enough, Panginoon. Maraming salamat, Lord. Lord, maraming salamat po sa buhay ng lahat ng iyong ginamit, Father God. Thank you, Father God, that through them, Lord, that victory overflow, Father God. And ganun din sa buhay ng lahat na nakasama namin ngayong araw na to, including those people online, because in their presence, there is, Lord, that spirit of fellowship, Father God. And in their presence itself, Father God, is an act of intercession with one another. Kaya, Father, maraming salamat po sa buhay ng bawat isa. Lord, our ultimate prayer, Father God, is that fire that has been rekindled in our heart. Father God, we pray na selyuhan mo po. We pray na pangalagaan mo po, Panginoon. We pray, Father God, na panghawakan mo po ang aming buhay. Panghawakan mo po, Father God, itong flesh na to and the desire of the flesh. Panghawakan mo po ang aming isipan, ang aming emosyon, ang aming puso. Panghawakan mo ang aming mga kamay, ang kanyang mga gawa, ang aming bibig. Bunganga, Father, dila, Father, ang aming mga yapak, Father God, that Lord, hindi po sana kami, Father God, muling lumayo sa iyo. That Father God, hindi po madali, Father God, ang lumakad kasama ka, Lord, dahil the world will always try its scheme to pull us away from you. But Father, so as long as we continue to draw near to you, katulad ng iyong mga salita, thank you, Father God, because there is that principle of fire and getting near you, Father God. Sabi nga namin, Lord, na kung ang kahoy nababad sa tubig, pag sa apoy ay nalapit, ay magliliyab din. Gaano man kami nababad sa mundong ito, gaano man kami nababad, nasadlak sa makasalanan ng mundong ito, gaano man ang tawag sa amin ng mundo ay kasalanan, hindi na makasalanan, kundi kasalanan. But Father, maraming salamat dahil sa paglapit namin sa iyo. That Father God, we will become fire. Magiging apoy kami, Father God. Hindi na kami kasalanan, hindi na kami makasalanan, bagkus kami ay magiging apoy, Father God. And Lord, our prayer through the virtue of the power of your Holy Spirit, Panginoon, that yung apoy na yan ay patuloy na maglagablab, Father God. Lord, tulungan mo po ang bawat isa na mailakad, Father God, na mapangalagaan, Lord, ang kanilang salvation na natanggap sa iyo, Father God, na may buong fear, Father, na may buong takot at pangamba sa iyo, Panginoon. Maraming salamat. We are excited, Lord, of how you are going to reveal yourself this week, Father God. And we know, Lord, that as we enter this Holy Week, Father God, Lord, you will be victorious, you will be powerful upon the life of each and everyone, Lord. Healing will overflow to people. Deliverance will overflow to people, Father God. Problems will be resolved, Father. Weakness will be strengthened, Father God. Tiredness will be renewed, Father God. Lord, yung kakulangan will be filled up, Father God. The lack will be provided for, Panginoon. Because, Father, on that day, 2,000 years ago, these are all the fulfillment of your promise, Panginoon. Kaya, Lord, tinatanggap po namin by faith, Father God. We apply it in our life by faith, in the life of your church, in the life of your people, in the life of families by faith, Father God. Lord, thank you for the testimony that you are going to make, Lord, this Holy Week coming. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. May God bless you all, church.